It's one of the world's most impressive airports. Located in Osaka, Japan, this engineering marvel is none other than Kansai International Airport. Opened in 1994, it was built on an immense artificial island. With over 30 million passengers in 2019, the airport is today an essential gateway for national and international air traffic. It will be Osaka's showcase and gateway in 2025, when the Japanese city hosts the next World Expo. However, from its construction to its recent renovation, this infrastructure has always had to reinvent itself to avoid disappearing between the risks of sinking and financial problems. A turbulent history that is far from over, as we'll see today in this new episode of Looking For. Before packing your luggage and checking your passport, it's time to take a step back in time, because, prodigious as it is, Kansai International Airport rose from the sea in great pain. The idea for a new airport dates back to the late 1960s. To support the region's economic development, it was decided to build new infrastructures. The authorities seemed to want to expand the existing airport at Itami. In operation since 1939 and already extended once in the 1950s, it appeared to be reaching full capacity. What's more, the airport faces a major problem. Caught up by urbanization, it finds itself in a densely populated urban environment. Expanding it would mean expropriating many people and increasing nuisance to the surrounding area. In the end, this possibility was ruled out. Many other options were then put forward to find a location that would cause the least possible disturbance to the population, while still being able to operate 24/7. But none seemed suitable. Then, an innovative project arose. Why not build an airport in an area where no one else has settled yet, on the waters of Osaka Bay? A surprising choice at first glance, but one that is typical of Japanese urban planning. The land of the rising sun is faced with a constant shortage of space, a constraint that has led to the construction of numerous artificial islands to relieve urban congestion. As a result, the idea gained ground and a site was chosen for the future airport. It's located southwest of Osaka, some 30 kilometers from the city center. Opposite are three towns in Osaka Prefecture: Izumisano, Tajiri, and Sennan. Officially, the airport extends over these three municipalities, each of which has received a part of the artificial island in its district. It's hard to say whether the environmental impact of such a project has been taken into account. The only certainty is that the project cost billions of dollars. Construction began in 1987 with the aim of building an artificial island 4 kilometers long. The first stage was a titanic one, as the site had to be drained. In 1989, a dike was completed. It consisted of several thousand tetrapods, concrete blocks designed to keep the structure dry. The next step was to fill the gaping hole in Osaka Bay. To do this, 80 ships took it in turns to bring in the tens of millions of cubic meters of material needed to build the embankment. The material was removed directly from three nearby mountains. Almost 10,000 workers were involved, filling this giant hole over 30 meters deep. In 1991, the 3.7 kilometers long bridge linking the island to the coast was inaugurated. Called the Sky Gate Bridge, it comprises two levels. Upstairs, six lanes of motorway traffic, and downstairs, a railway line. It is considered as one of the world's longest truss bridges and cost almost $1 billion to build. But if the project goes ahead, a problem will soon arise. The island is sinking, and it's doing so dangerously, between 8 and 10 meters according to estimates. The main reason for this is that the weight of the materials used in construction has compressed the seabed. This impact had been taken into account at the outset, but not to such an extent. So to avoid seeing the work already done disappear, a clever solution was found. It took the form of over 1 million adjustable piles to support the terminal and the runways. Sinking to a depth of almost 80 meters, they are combined with a powerful system of hydraulic jacks, and sensors detect the movements of the piles at all times so that they can be adjusted to maintain the platform's balance. This incredible system not only resists earthquakes, but also drastically slows down the subsidence of the artificial island, even if this is still closely watched by experts. It wasn't until 1994 that the terminal, designed by the famous architect Renzo Piano, went into service. The architect, who also designed the Centre Pompidou in Paris with Richard Rogers, imagined an undulating building. This aesthetic architectural signature facilitates air ventilation inside this enormous building. So gigantic that a monorail had to be installed to allow users to move from one end to the other. At 1.7 kilometers long, the terminal ranks as one of the world's longest buildings. But shortly after its inauguration, the construction site is already causing some concern. In total, it has cost over $20 billion, a third more than the planned budget. The majority of the costs are being covered by the Japanese government, and to compensate for this staggering hole in the coffers, entrance fees to use the airport have been revised upwards. The landing tax, which every plane arriving at an airport must pay, has become one of the most expensive in the world. Calculated on a per-ton basis, it stands at $24 per ton at Kansai Airport, twice as much as at Charles de Gaulle Airport in Paris at the same time. When it concerns aircraft weighing several hundred tons, this kind of multiplication can quickly give airlines a headache. As a result, initial flight forecasts were revised downwards, with 328 flights per week instead of the double number originally planned. A gloomy picture, completed by the natural disasters that hit Japan and the new structure. On January 17, 1995, a terrible earthquake shook the country, killing several thousand people. Although located less than 20 kilometers from the epicenter, the airport did not suffer any damage, thanks in particular to its seismic resistance system. In 1998, a typhoon with winds in excess of 200 kilometers per hour also caused no material damage. Unfortunately, however, the structure was not always so fortunate in the face of natural disasters, as we shall see shortly. Soon after its opening, lessons were learned from this epic construction for similar projects such as Hong Kong Airport, which opened in 1998. Much closer by, on the other side of Osaka Bay in Kobe, an airport on an artificial island is under construction. Despite a substantial budget deficit, Kansai Airport soon reached full capacity. Planned from the outset, the expansion project was launched in 2003. The same technique was used, namely the construction of a new artificial island located 200 meters from the first. At 535 hectares, it is slightly larger than the first. The new project took over 4 years to complete. In 2007, the new runway was inaugurated. This new infrastructure considerably increased the airport's capacity and profitability, enabling it to operate 24 hours a day. But despite this tenfold increase in operations, 20 million passengers in 2015, and due to poor financial health, the administrative region of Kansai decided to hand over the concession of two of its airports. Itami Airport and Kansai Airport were officially privatized in 2016. Since then, they have been managed by a joint venture between financial services company Oryx and Vinci Airports, a subsidiary of the Vinci Group, which has been awarded the concession until 2060 for an estimated $650 million. These two companies own 40% of the shares, with the remainder held by local businesses. Vinci has been appointed operator of the site, and this is not a first, since the French group already manages some 70 airports worldwide. As part of this regional privatization drive, a third airport in the region, this time in Kobe, has also been handed over to the joint venture in 2018. As with Kansai Airport, the lease runs until 2060. It was also in 2018 that the airport had to face another weather disaster with the passage of Typhoon Jebi, a tropical cyclone of rare intensity, even for a region used to this kind of weather phenomenon. Devastating and plunging part of Japan into mourning, it also altered life at the airport. An out-of-control oil tanker crashed into the bridge linking the airport to the mainland. The heavily damaged bridge was closed, leaving several thousand people stranded at the airport. The typhoon also flooded much of the airport's infrastructure, causing extensive material damage. Although all travelers and employees were evacuated, the airport had to be shut down for almost 10 days before it could be brought back into service. To deal with these problems, the joint venture will be putting its hand in the wallet, initially spending over $340 million. The aim of the work is to secure the site. To this end, the protective walls are being raised and some 40,000 new tetrapods are being placed around the islands to break the waves. The electrical installations, badly damaged by the typhoon, are being made safe. And in the next few years, solar panels should also be installed to provide part of the infrastructure's energy consumption. Next, a second phase of renovation is underway. The aim is to modernize the airport in depth, with the dual objective of increasing passenger capacity and making it a showcase of refinement. This second objective is particularly relevant in view of the next World Expo. It will be held in Osaka in 2025. For almost 6 months, the airport will be the main gateway for tourists from all over the world to attend the event. To achieve this, $500 million have been spent to completely rethink the airport's operation and change its interior appearance. Inaugurated in December 2023, the new facilities should enable traffic to increase from 32 million passengers in 2019 to 40 million, in particular to anticipate the massive influx of tourists at the World Expo in 2025. At the same time, security systems are to be modernized. A way of ensuring that the incredible escape affair that affected the airport at the end of 2019 never happens again. Indeed, it was from Kansai International Airport that Carlos Ghosn, former Renault CEO actively sought in Japan, was able to flee the country to take refuge in Lebanon. Taking advantage of a more flexible checkpoint for hold luggage on private jets, Carlos Ghosn, aided by two accomplices, hid in a large box of audio equipment and managed to leave Japanese territory without making a sound. In addition to this modernization, the renovations have also given pride of place to luxury with the use of noble materials such as marble. This luxury is also evident in the new shopping mall through which all travelers pass. In fact, there are some real firsts here. Louis Vuitton chose Kansai International Airport to open its first boutique in this type of infrastructure. Similarly, the world's first airport Dior Cafe is located in the same place. A top-to-bottom renovation which for a time dispels the risk of the infrastructure disappearing. The ground is still shifting a little beneath its feet, although the phenomenon seems to be under control, but the vagaries of the climate, which are tending to intensify as global temperatures rise, could once again play spoil sport. A marvel of engineering, Kansai International Airport remains a fragile jewel in the crown of world aviation. All right, that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching and see you soon on Looking 4.